Hi students, welcome to the channel NCERT Maths Tutor. If you like this video, please click the like button, share and subscribe. In this video, I am explaining the solution of miscellaneous exercise question number 8, 9, 10 of chapter 3 trigonometric functions. Find sin x by 2, cos x by 2 and tan x by 2 in each of the following. First we have 8th question. Tan x is equal to minus 4 by 3 x in quadrant second. So here to find out this one, we need to first find the value of cos x. Because we can use the formula here to find sin theta by 2 and cos theta by 2. These kind of formulas we can use. Here cos 2 theta is equal to 1 minus 2 sin square theta. So that cos theta means in the place of 2 theta, if you put here theta, so that this formula becomes 1 minus 2 sin square theta by 2. Then if you bring this to this side, minus become plus. So 2 sin square theta by 2 is equal to 1 minus cos theta. Sin square theta by 2 is equal to 1 minus cos theta. That means sin theta by 2 is equal to square root of 1 minus cos theta divided by 2. So this formula we can use to find sin theta by 2. In the same way, to find the cos theta by 2, you can use the formula cos theta by 2 is equal to square root of 1 plus cos theta divided by 2. So these formulas we are going to use. And once you find the cos theta by 2 and sin theta by 2, then you can easily find out the tan theta by 2. So now here, first step is finding the cos value. Because to find anything sin theta by 2 or cos theta by 2, we need here cos value. So first here we will find the cos value. So we know now the tan x value. Tan x is equal to minus 4 by 3. So we know the formula 1 plus tan square x is equal to sec square x. So just put the value of tan x here. So sec square x is equal to 1 plus tan square x. We know that tan x is equal to minus 4 by 3. So minus 4 by 3 whole square. So that is equal to 1 plus 4 square 16 divided by 3 square 9. So that is equal to, if you take the common denominator as 9, so this become 9 into 1, 9 plus 16 divided by 9 is equal to 25 divided by 9. So sec square x is equal to 25 divided by 9. So sec x is equal to plus or minus 5 by 3. So here we have both plus and minus. In the question they have given that the x lies in the second quadrant. And in the second quadrant, sine is positive. Sine as well as cosec is positive. So sec x is negative. So here I am taking the negative value of this sec x. So sec x is equal to minus pi by 3. If sec x is minus pi by 3, then cos x is equal to minus 3 by 5. Because we know that cos x is equal to 1 by sec x. So here we can easily get the value of cos x. Cos x is equal to minus 3 by 5. Next, as we got the cos x value, now we can use the formula sin theta by 2 is equal to square root of 1 minus cos theta divided by 2. So here I am writing the formula in the place of theta, I am writing x. So sin x by 2 is equal to square root of 1 minus cos x divided by 2. So that is equal to square root of 1 minus cos x value is minus 3 by 5. So minus 3 by 5 divided by 2. Here we have minus minus, so that it becomes plus. So square root of 1 plus 3 by 5 divided by 2. Now here for this, if you take the common denominator as 5, then here we get the answer as 5. Then 5 into 1, 5 plus 3 divided by 2. Then if you perform the cross multiplication, this 2 become half. So here we have 8 divided by 5 into half. So 2 1s are 2 4s are, after cancellation we get here square root of 4 by 5, that is equal to square root of 4 is 2, 2 divided by square root of 5. Next, sine, here we have the square root of 5 in the denominator. So now we can't leave the answer, we can't leave the denominator value as square root. So that's why if you find square root in the denominator, you have to rationalize. Rationalize means you need to multiply denominator as well as numerator. So here we have square root of 5. So we have to eliminate that. So that's why I'm multiplying square root of 5 in the numerator as well as in the denominator. So when I multiply, it becomes, see here we have this one become 2 square root of 5 divided by this one becomes square root of 25. Square root of 25 is 5. So here we get the answer 2 square root of 5 divided by 5. So now here we got sine x by 2 value. Sine x by 2 is equal to 2 square root of 5 divided by 5. Now here we have to see that whether this value is positive or not. See, in the question they have given that x lies in the second quadrant. Second quadrant means it is 90 to 180 degree. So pi by 2 less than x less than pi. Pi by 2 means 90, 90 less than x less than 180. So if you divide this one, all the values divided by 2 if you perform, so that it becomes 90 by 2 less than x less than 180 by 2. So this value become 45 less than x less than 90. Divided by 2, this should be divided by 2, x divided by 2. So this one become x by 2. So x by 2 lies between 45 and 90 degree. 45 and 90 degree means it is the first quadrant. And in the first quadrant, all the values are positive. That means sine x by 2 is also positive. Then next here, we need to find out the cos x by 2. To find the cos x by 2, again we have to use the same kind of formula that we have used for sin x by 2. See here we have the formula cos 2 theta is equal to 2 cos square theta minus 1. So here you can make the slight changes in this formula. Here we have 2 theta. In the place of 2 theta, I am writing here theta. So that this one become theta by 2, because if you have your 2 theta, this is half of this one. So cos theta means this one become 2 cos square theta by 2 minus 1. So now here this minus 1 you can bring this side, so that it become cos theta plus 1 is equal to 2 cos square theta divided by 2. Then this 2 you can bring, divide the values, this one, this 2 you can bring this side, so that cos theta plus 1 divided by 2 is equal to cos square theta by 2. So cos theta by 2 is equal to square root of 1 plus cos theta divided by 2. So by using this formula, you can find the value of cos x by 2. See here, we know the value of cos x, that is minus 3 by 5. So just replace the value. So square root of 1 minus 3 by 5 divided by 2, that is equal to square root of, if you take the common denominator as 5, the value becomes 5 minus 3 divided by 5 divided by 2. Then after performing the cross multiplication, this one becomes half, 2 become half. So here we have 2 by 5 into half. So 2 get cancelled. So here we have square root of 1 by 5. Square root of 1 is 1, 1 divided by square root of 5. Again here in the denominator we have square root, so you have to rationalize the value. So just multiply square root of 5 to the both sides, so that we can eliminate the square root value in the denominator. So 1 by square root of 5 we have, so I am multiplying square root of 5, square root of 5. So that this one becomes square root of 5 divided by this one becomes square root of 25, and that is equal to 5. So square root of 5 divided by 5. So x cos x by 2 is equal to square root of 5 divided by 5. Again here you can see that the value x by 2 lies in the first quadrant itself. It is in between 45 to 90 degree. That means it is first quadrant, and in the first quadrant all the trigonometric functions are positive. So that's why here this value is positive only. Then we have tan x by 2. Tan x by 2, to find that we are not using the separate formula. Instead of that, we know that tan x is nothing but sin x upon cos x. So we know the value of sin x by 2 now and cos x by 2. So sin x by 2 divided by cos x by 2. Sin x by 2 is 2 square root of 5 divided by 5 divided by, then cos x by 2 is square root of 5 divided by 5. Now you perform the cross multiplication. So it becomes 2 square root of 5 divided by 5. This will go up and this will come down. So 5 divided by square root of 5. Perform the cancellation here. And after cancellation, we get the value 2. So here we get the final value as cos x by 2 is equal to square root of 5 divided by 5. Sin x by 2 is equal to 2 square root of 5 divided by 5. And tan x by 2 is equal to 2. Next here we will see the next problem, ninth problem. Ninth problem is cos x is equal to minus 1 by 3 x in quadrant third. X lies in quadrant third. So now here they have directly given the cos x value. So we can directly put the value of cos x in the formula and directly we can get the value here. Whereas in the previous case they have given us tan x. So by using some Pythagorean identity formula, we have found out the cos value, then we use this formula. But now here we can directly use the formula as we know the cos value. So you can find out either cos theta by 2 or sin theta by 2. So cos theta by 2 is equal to square root of 1 plus cos theta divided by 2. Just put the value of cos theta. So here we get cos x by 2 is equal to square root of 1 minus 1 by 3 divided by 2. So if you take the common denominator here, this one become square root of 3 minus 1 divided by 3 divided by 2. This one become so that 2 by 3 divided by 2 square root of. So here we have, if you perform the cross multiplication, this become half, 2 to get cancelled. Then we get square root of 1 by 3, that is equal to 1 divided by root square root of 3. So now again here in the denominator we have the value that is square root. So we have to rationalize the answer. So just multiply square root of 3 both the sides so that we get here square root of 3 divided by this one becomes square root of 9. So that is nothing but 3. So root 3 square root of 3 divided by 3 we have here. This is the cos x by 2 value. Then here we have to see whether this value is positive or not. See in the question they have given that x lies in the third quadrant. Third quadrant means it is in between 180 degree to 270 degree. So 180 to 270 degree. Now if you divide this one for this x divided by 2 if you perform so that this one become 180 by 2, this one become x by 2 and this one become 270 divided by 2. 180 by 2 means 90 less than this is x by 2 less than 135 degree. So the x by 2 value lies in between 90 to 135 degree. That means it is second quadrant. And in the second quadrant, sine and cosec are positive and other trigonometric ratios are negative. That means for this cos x by 2, you have to put the negative sign minus square root of 3 divided by 3. Next here we will find the sin x by 2 value. So for that we use the formula sin theta by 2 is equal to square root of 1 minus cos theta divided by 2. We know that cos theta is minus 1 by 3. So just put the value so that sin x by 2 is equal to square root of 1 minus minus 1 by 3 divided by 2. This one become plus here. So square root of 1 plus 1 by 3 divided by 2. So if you take the common denominator here, this one become 3 into 1, 3 plus 1 divided by 3 divided by 2. Then again that is equal to square root of 4 by 3 divided by 2. So again after cross multiplication, square root of 4 by 3 into half, 2 ones are 2 twos are. So that is equal to square root of 2 by 3. That is equal to square root of 2 divided by square root of 3. Now again here we have a square root in the denominator. So you have to rationalize the value, final answer. So just multiply root 3, square root of root 3 in the denominator as well as in the numerator. So that square root of 2 divided by square root of 3 into square root of 3 divided by square root of 3. So this one become, here we have square root symbol. We are multiplying the square root values. So both the values are inside the square root. So it becomes 2 into 3, that is 6. So square root of 6 divided by 3 into 3, that is square root of 9. We know the square root of 9 value, that is 3. So square root of 6 divided by 3. So now here we don't have a square root symbol in the denominator. So sin x by 2 is equal to square root of 6 divided by 3. Then here we have to see this sin. See here we know that x by 2 lies in between 90 to 135 degree. That means it is second quadrant. And in the second quadrant sin and cosec are positive. So here for sin x by 2 I am taking plus value only. That is square root of 6 divided by 3. Next, now here we know the value of tan sin x as well as the cos x. So by using that, we can now find out the value of tan x by 2. So tan x by 2 is equal to tan x is sin upon cos. So tan x by 2 is equal to sin x by 2 upon cos x by 2. Now just put the value of both here. We know the value of sin x by 2, that is square root of 6 divided by 3 divided by minus square root of 3 divided by 3. Again here, after cross multiplication, we get square root of 6 divided by 3. So minus 3 divided by minus square root of 3. 3, 3 get cancelled. So square root of 2. Then here we get the final value as that is for this square root of 6 divided by minus square root of 3. See, this 6 you can write as, this is nothing but 2 into 3, right? So you can write this one as square root of 2 into square root of 3. So now again here you can cancel this square root of 3. Then you get the final answer as minus square root of 2. So here we got the answer sin x by 2 is equal to square root of 6 by 3, cos x by 2 is equal to minus square root of 3 by 3, and tan x by 2 is equal to minus square root of 2. Next, here we have the final problem of miscellaneous exercise, that is sin x is equal to 1 by 4 x in quadrant second. So here they have given the sin x value and they have given that x lies in the second quadrant. See, to use the formula of 1 plus cos theta square root of 1 plus cos theta divided by 2 for sin theta by 2 or cos theta by 2, we need the value of cos x. But in the problem, they have given the value of sin x. So now by using the Pythagorean identities, we can find the value of cos x. Then later we can use the formula. So sin x is equal to 1 by 4. From the Pythagorean identity, we know that sin square x plus cos square x is equal to 1. So cos square x is equal to 1 minus sin square x. Just put the value of sin x here. So 1 minus 1 by 4 whole square, that is equal to 1 minus 1 by 16. Here the denominator, common denominator is 16. So 16 minus 1 divided by 16, that is equal to 15 divided by 16. So cos x is equal to square root of 15 by 16, that is equal to plus or minus square root of plus or minus, here we have square root of 15 divided by 4 here. Square root of 16 is 4. Then here we have to choose the symbol, which symbol is suitable for, sign is suitable for cos x, that we have to see. See here in the question, they have given that x lies in the second quadrant, and in the second quadrant, sine and cosec are positive and other trigonometric ratios are negative. That means for this, you can choose the negative symbol, that is cos x is equal to minus square root of 15 divided by 4. Now, as we got the value of cos x, we can easily find out cos x by 2 and sin x by 2. See, from the formula, we know that cos theta by 2 is equal to square root of 1 plus cos theta divided by 2. So, cos x by 2 is equal to square root of, the value of this cos theta is minus square root of 15 divided by 4. So, just put the value here, square root of 1 minus square root of 15 divided by 4 divided by 2. Then again, if you take the common denominator here, so this become 4 minus square root of 15 divided by 4 divided by 2. Then after cross multiplication here, we get 4 minus square root of 15 divided by 4 into half. So here 2 into 4, that is 8. 4 square root of 4 minus square root of 15 divided by 8. So that is equal to square root of 4 minus square root of 15 divided by square root of 8. This 8 we can write as 4 into 2, and we know that square root of 4 is 2, so that 2 will come out, so that here we get square root of 4 minus square root of 15 divided by 2 square root of 2. Now again, this value, this particular answer has a denominator, square root symbol in the denominator, so that's why we have to rationalize the answer. So cos x by 2 is equal to square root of 4 minus square root of 15 divided by 2 square root of 2. So just multiply square root of 2 to both the sides, so that here we get the answer. See, this one here we have square root of 2, just you have to multiply to this. So 2 into 4, that is 8, square root of 8 minus square root of 2 into, then here we have square root of 15 So that, see, in this case, when you multiply, this is not 15 into 2 is equal to 30, because here you have a square root of symbol, as well as again for this, you have one more square root of symbol. So that's why you can't perform here direct multiplication. Here we have double square root symbol for this 15. So you can write this one as inside square root 2 into square root of 15. See, whereas in this case, you have just 4, so that you can multiply this one 2 into 4, that one becomes 8. So here 2 into square root of 15 divided by this one become 2 into square root of 4. So square root of 4 is 2. So square root of 8 minus 2 square root of 15 divided by 2 into 2. That is equal to square root of 8 minus 2 divided by, square root of 15 divided by 4. So here now we got the value of sine theta by cos theta, cos x by 2. Now again you can see the identify the sine here. In the question they have given that x lies in the second quadrant, that means 90 to 180 degree. Now divided by 2, so that 90 by 2 less than x by 2 less than 180 by 2. This one become 45 less than x by 2 less than 90. That means here x by 2 lies in the first quadrant itself, and in the first quadrant all the trigonometric ratios are positive. So here we get cos x by 2 as positive only. Then next you find the sine theta by 2 or sine x by 2. For that we have the formula sine theta by 2 is equal to square root of 1 minus cos theta divided by 2. So sine x by 2 is equal to square root of 1 minus square root of 15 divided by 4 divided by 2. So that is equal to square root of 1 plus square root of 15 divided by 4 divided by 2, minus minus become plus, then take the common denominator 4. So 4 plus square root of 15 divided by 4 into half. So that is 4 plus square root of 15 divided by 8. So that here we have square root of 8, that we can write as 4 into 2. So that we get here square root of 4 plus square root of 15 divided by square root of 4 into 2. Square root of 4 is 2. So square root of 4 plus square root of 15 divided by 2 into square root of 2. So here again in the denominator we have square root symbol. That means we have to rationalize the value. We have to multiply numerator as well denominator with the square root of 2. So sine x by 2 is equal to square root of 4 plus square root of 15 divided by 2 square root of 2 into square root of 2 divided by square root of 2. So when you multiply, see here we have square root symbol. Here also we have one square root symbol. So directly you can multiply 2 into 4, that is 8 plus. Whereas in this case you have double square root symbol. Here we have 1. So you can't multiply 15 into 2. So this one becomes 2 into square root of 15 divided by 2 into square root of 4. 2 into 2, that is 4. So here you can take this 4 out. That is square root of 4 is 2. So square root of 8 plus 2 square root of 15 divided by 2 into 2. That is, we get the answer of sine x by 2 as square root of 8 plus 2 square root of 15 divided by 4. Next, as we know the value of sine x by 2 and cos x by 2, we can find the value of tan x by 2. Tan x by 2 is equal to sine x by 2 divided by cos cos x by 2. Cos x by 2. Then sine x by 2 value is square root of 8 plus 2 square root of 15 divided by 4 divided by square root of 8 minus 2 square root of 15 divided by 4. Now you perform the cross multiplication. When you perform the cross multiplication, this 4 4 get cancelled. We get here square root of 8 plus 2 square root of 15 divided by square root of 8 minus 2 square root of 15. Now again here in the denominator we have the square root symbol. That means you have to rationalize the value. Just multiply both the side with this one plus here, so that we can eliminate this square root symbol. So square root of 8 plus 2 square root of 15 into square root of 8 plus 2 square root of 15 divided by square root of 8 minus 2 square root of 15 into square root of 8 plus 2 into square root of 15. See, now here this is nothing but a into a. We can write as a square. If you have here a into a, that is nothing but a square. So here we have, if you take this quantity as a and this one as a, so here we can write this one as 8 plus 2 square root of 15 whole square. This one, inside this one square root symbol. See, for example, if you have, let us say that here you have square root of a and here you have square root of a, then we write that one as while multiplying a into a. That is nothing but a square itself. Inside the square root symbol you can write. So same concept I am using here. We have here here, hey, this is just one, you can multiply, so that 8 plus 2 square root of 15 whole square. This one you can write in terms of the formula. We know that a square minus b square is equal to a plus b into a minus b. So here we have a plus b, that is 8 minus 2 square root of 15, this one. Then this is nothing but a plus b, 8 plus 2 square root of 15. You can take this one as a and this one as b. This one as a and this part as b. So now it is in the form a plus b into a minus b. So you can use this formula so that it becomes square root of 8 whole square minus 2 square root of 15 whole square. Then again, see, here we have a square symbol, then here we have square root symbol, this one get cancelled with this, so that here we get 8 plus 2 square root of 15 divided by 8 square is 64, square root of 64 minus 2 into 2, that is 4 into, here we have a square root symbol, so that here this one get cancelled with this, so that we get here 15. So that is 8 plus 2 square root of 15 divided by square root of 64 minus 60, that is equal to, if you take here 2 out, 2 is common in both the cases, so this one become 4 plus square root of 15 divided by square root of 4. Square root of 4 is 2, so here 2 into 4 plus square root of 15 divided by 2, 2 to get cancelled, so here we get 4 plus square root of 15. So for this problem, we get the answer cos x by 2 is equal to square root of 8 minus 2 square root of 15 divided by 2, sin x by 2 is equal to square root of 8 plus 2 square root of 15 divided by 4, and tan x by 2 is equal to 4 plus square root of 15. If you like this video, please subscribe to the channel NCERT Maths Tutor to get more regular updates. Thanks for watching.